My name is Olivia Hoblit of the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation. We've put together this concert series to help fulfill our mission to spread awareness on brain aneurysm and stroke. We've got some great music to share with you, along with inspiring stories and those who have been deeply affected by this condition. Thank you, Crane Island, for sponsoring this series.
Not break the ice, you melt the ice, you melt yourself, and soon you're all one puddle. You talk, he talks, it's not about the conversation. The words are like your lips are reaching out to kiss the of water, the pull, invisible but really real. Her eyes, your eyes, and soon you're looking in a mirror. You realize you can't get nearer, you are both right there. You glow, she glows, two suns, no shadow. Her skin, your skin, and everything's alright. No edge, no edge, no walls, no border. Two streams of water that become the sea. Only looking in a mirror, you realize you can't get nearer, you are both right there. Your eyes, you're only looking in the mirror, you realize you can't get nearer, and there's nowhere you don't.
Trinity Love Hoblit was born with a rare form of primordial dwarfism. At age 9, Trinity was diagnosed with multiple brain aneurysms. In 2015, 2 days prior to pre-op for brain surgery to repair an aneurysm, it ruptured. Trinity passed away on June 30th, 2015, at age 14.
Our foundation's goal is to support and fund neurological research, training, treatments, and education toward brain aneurysm, stroke, and other cerebrovascular conditions.
So brain aneurysm is a weakness in the wall of an artery inside the brain that results in a, most of the time, a sac in the aneurysm that can lead to bleeding.
I woke up in the middle of the night at my mom's house, and I heard her yelling my name. And I ran in, and she was face down on the floor. It was a few days later, she passed away, but she had a brain aneurysm. Something I didn't know anything about,
To the best of my knowledge, I don't have anybody with a brain aneurysm. My risk is about 4%, give or take. If you have one family member, first degree, so if my mom had an aneurysm, it goes from 4 to 6%. If you have two family members, now you double your chance of having an aneurysm, it goes from 4 to 8%.
So with the strong encouragement from Olivia at the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation, I went to my doctor and I said, I have a request. I'd like to be scanned for a brain aneurysm. Fortunately, everything came back normal. And I'm very thankful for the results, but it's something that I now know that I've got to continue on and have the routine check.
It makes sense to find this before because we have something in 2020 to offer that we didn't have 20, 30 years ago. So that's the task ahead of us. What we're doing with in collaboration with Professor Landero from Brazil, with the support of the Trinity Hoblit Foundation and Neurosurgery Outreach Foundation, is to support young neurosurgeons that are still residents in Brazil, in Vietnam, in the Philippines, outside of the US, on the areas that we can reach people and educate them so they can go back and be an agent of change on their own environment.
Trinity love helping others. So my husband and I knew that this is very important. This is something that Trinity would want us to do.
My heart is always very, very thankful. Sad because Trinity is not here, but happy because her legacy is here and she's helping others, and I can see her smiling and point her little finger at me. I told you I was gonna do it. So that's Trinity, and she's alive with us.
To learn more about the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation or to make a donation, visit trinityhoblit.org.
What would I do without your smart mouth? Drawing me in and you kicking me out. Got my head spinning, no kidding. I can't pin you down. What's going on in that beautiful mind? I'm on your magical mystery ride. And I'm so dizzy, don't know what hit me. But I'll be alright. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me. I'll give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me. You give me all of you. Oh. How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world keeps bringing you down. I'm around through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse. My worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my head for you. My head's underwater, but I'm breathing fine. You're crazy and I'm out of my mind. 'Cause all of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me. My all to you. You're my end and my beginning. Even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me. And you give me all. showing heart, risking it all, though it's hard. All of me loves all of you. Love your curves and all your edges, all your perfect imperfections. Give your all to me, or give my all to you. You're my end and my beginning, even when I lose, I'm winning. 'Cause I give you all of me, and you give me all of you. I give you all of me, and you give me all of you.
We're here at Crane Island in a beautiful island, Amelia Island, Florida. Thank you, Crane Island, for sponsoring this whole series for us. It's for a great cause. And thank you all so much for being with us. This concert series is to spread the awareness on stroke and brain aneurysm. And we have with us is Dr. Ricardo Hanel, who has been a great supporter of the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation. And thank you so much, Dr. Hanel, for all you do. And we also have Larson Sikas with us. And Larson, did I pronounce that correctly?
Yep.
Oh, great. And we also have his mother named Susana Sikas, which again, Susana is the way we pronounce my mom's name in Filipino. So thank you all so much for being here with us. Larson, I've heard about an inspiring story from your mother and Dr. Ricardo Hanel. So why don't you tell us a little bit about, your story and share it with our viewers?
Yep. So I was an all-A student, marching band, honors classes. I was about to step into the shower to take a regular shower on Wednesday, December 16th, 2015. When I all of a sudden had the worst headache imaginable, started screaming for somebody to come. Wow. And I somewhat remember this. Dad came and asked me what's wrong hurriedly, and I told him I have the worst headache while passing out and puking. I was taking up the emergency part of Baptist, where the doctors decided me on going up to Weaver 10 to see Dr. Ricardo Hanel. He did a quick MRI on me and discovered that I had a ruptured brain aneurysm, no big deal. All he had to do was go in through my groin and coil it using, go into my groin and work all the way up to my brain where it was bleeding and stuff it from the inside using the coiling method. I recovered over Christmas break and I got discharged a day or two before New Year's, where I went back to making all A's, marching band, honors classes, up until Thursday, March 10th, 2016. That day was a half day at Trinity, so Mom picked my younger brother Andrew and I up early. She left Andrew and I home alone while she went and picked up Wesley. She got a random phone call from me, but she couldn't answer it because her cellular reception was poor. So she just was a little puzzled, so she took her time coming home, right? She unlocks the front door, and she says, "Larson," and she couldn't find me, but then Andrew eventually shows up and tells her that Larson puked. He led her to my father's side of the bed, which is really difficult to find the first place, where, according to Mom, I was covered with vomit all over me. So this time she called 911. The ambulance immediately came. We live on a dead end of one of the courts of our neighborhood. The whole court had a little party seeing what was going on with the ambulance coming to the end of the court. And then I was immediately rushed back to Baptist, right up to Weaver 10, right back to Dr. Hanel. But Dr. Hanel had, an assistant in Dr. Savageau. At that time, I cover my hair. I comb my hair over my incision, but I'm not sure if I can show y'all it. Dr. Hanel had to go into my head and use the clipping method to obliterate the aneurysm. He also had to insert a shunt in April Wait, no. Was it March or April 2016?
I think it was April 1st.
Yeah, April 1st, 2016. So all I did was rest a whole bunch, and mom eventually chose for me to transfer from the medical hospital once I got all the medical complications out of the way to the rehabilitation hospital in Brooks Rehabilitation Hospital on Southside University. So while I was there, my tone pattern, so my therapists were expecting my tone pattern to start off really, really horrible and then eventually progress. But when I got there, my tone pattern started out fine. And then the tone really started to kick in. And that's when I had to have some very, very painful serial castings with the OT and her assistant. But I eventually got discharged Wednesday, May 25th, 2016. All I did, I'm pretty sure all of 2016 was just rest and rest and rest.
Wow, that's, you've been through so much. And
yeah, I haven't gone to more of it.
Yeah, and I'm sure that was very tiring for you, not knowing, you know, what to expect. And you were how old when this first happened?
Was it
14?
14.
It can happen at any age. Before going directly into that, Olivia, I want to say thank you for all that you do to increase awareness. And I appreciate Susanna, Dad, Larson, for coming here and sharing this with the world. It takes bravery to do this, Larson. And I can tell you're a grade A student because you remember all this right there. And you brought tears to my eyes because when you see a 14-year-old going through all this and through all the mom and dad and the family had to go with you, it's humbling. To hear that, and Susanna and I remember all the hours, but mom, it's different. So it's humbling to hear all this, and I remember a little detail on your story, Larson, that we were supposed to get an MRI the week after the second bleed.
Yes.
And because of Larson, actually, I changed my routine for patients with ruptured aneurysms, because re-rupture, re-bleeding, as Larson had, is a very rare event. But again, when it happened to a 14-year-old, you definitely won't forget that in your life. And I won't forget that you are about to get your 3-month follow-up. And now all my patients with ruptured aneurysms, I should get a follow-up picture a month after, because I'll never want to have anybody living through what you had to live through. And unfortunately, Madsen, we have no crystal balls. You have a very special aneurysm. And what he didn't tell you, Liv, is Larson, after the clipping, he had a regrowth of this aneurysm on the other side of the clip. And he needed another treatment, had a complication of that treatment, and had another treatment. So Larson went to 4 procedures.
Wow.
Or his brain aneurysm, and God permit, this last one that was done recently was the last one. It was a very challenging case. And in spite of all that, you talk to him, he's doing phenomenal. But he has aneurysms can happen at any age. The youngest person I've ever treated with a brain aneurysm was a 3-month-old, and the oldest was a 99-year-old lady. So it can happen to any of us.
So, doctor, with Larson's story, what are usually the symptoms to the children? Because I know sometimes the children will come up to us and say, oh, my belly's not feeling well, or my head's not feeling well. And we sometimes, you know, some parents, they go a different approach. What is your recommendation from your experience, you know, treating with the children?
Yeah, I think it's something that I think for the parents is very important to educate parents about that. It's very hard for a pediatrician or a kid's healthcare provider to order an MRI for everybody that has a headache. But Larson just described that on his case, hard to miss, worst headache of his life. But if you have a child that is having headaches,
yeah,
I think you need to have a low threshold to order picture. MRI brain these days, I'll give an example. Wolfson You can have kids as young as 4 years old, as long as the kid can be coached to get an MRI without sedation. So I think I have a low threshold for ordering an MRI brain for kids that have headache, because we see here and there brain tumors and brain aneurysms that I found because of that. But as a parent, if your child have a headache, was not a headache, again, some kids can have migraine, and migraine is not uncommon in kids as well. But a healthcare provider should be able to tell this is migraine or this is not migraine, or if this migraine is out of proportion. This headache is something that the kid never had before. Like Larson case, he's like marching band, grade A student, carry on his normal life. This child comes home complaining of headache, red flag. Don't run these little red flags, because this can happen and you can miss an opportunity to help your child. So don't downplay when a kid is complaining of a headache, because that could be a warning of something coming.
So that is really great information, because I know that we interviewed one of the patients last year as well, where he was just a 2 year old and thought that he just had a stomach ache, but the parent knew something was wrong because this is not typically him. And same thing, Susanna, you know, I'm sure you followed your gut as a mother, right? And as it turned out, they thought it was just a stomach bug in another hospital. They transported him to Wolfson Children's Hospital, and Dr. Sabisho and Dr. Hanel treated him. And actually, he had a ruptured brain aneurysm, and he was almost going to be sent home as a stomach virus.
So I remember this case, and that's what it's important. To go to a center that has pediatric specialized care. Because, again, a 14-year-old like Larson, super smart, very eloquent, he'll tell you what's wrong with him. My head hurts. But a toddler, he can barely talk. He might not be able to say that it's my head that is hurting. This kid was there vomiting, was not very clear what's going on, and they were downplaying it. This was a GI bug till his heart rate went really low. Then they realized that it was something wrong with his brain, and then they sent him to Wolfson. So from the parents' perspective, I know sometimes it's easier just to go to the closest place. Make sure not all physicians or hospitals are created equal. You gotta go to a place that has pediatric care, that there is a pediatrician or a physician trained to deal with kids, because this is very different situation, especially if you're dealing with the little ones that cannot tell you what's going on. So again, Larson at 14 is as smart or smarter than many grow up. So
yeah, plus Wolfson's is a lot more understanding towards my fear of needles.
Oh my gosh.
Something better than this. worth it coming easy. It'll never keep you satisfied. Yeah. Oh. And I see the brothers land in every tear I've cried. Oh, I know that there's gotta be something, something better than this. Oh, baby, something better than this, darling. It's gotta be, oh, something better, baby. Oh, something better than this, baby.
That's really great information. And Larson, sharing your story with everyone, being that you were 14 and you're so brave, right, to have to go through this, because again, I have a 15-year-old and Trinity was 14 when we lost her. And not just for children, but for also for the adults. Larson, because you've experienced it, what is your recommendation to our viewers?
If you see any abnormalities, I'd probably go over to the ER.
And don't ignore the symptoms. And time is so important.
Yep, it doesn't have to be head. It just needs to be anything, like stomach.
I'll say this to the paramedics who first came in December of 2015. They took his vitals. They said his vitals all look good. He was vomiting, so that's stomach virus is what they jumped to as well. And they were like, we don't really see a need to transport him. And you know, if I had insisted, they would have. But it was my mom who kind of
was familiar. It was grandma.
Yeah,
she was the real MVP there.
Yeah, well, she was the one that kind of.
Yeah, I probably noticed. Err on the side of caution.
Yeah, and she kind of realized what the symptoms might mean.
Yeah,
and you know, so
this was on the second time, Susanna?
The first time,
yeah.
She's the one who brought me over to you.
Yeah, and so, you know, my dad and I drove him to Wolfson's, but, you know, had something gone south on the trip there, you know, we would have been in shape. Yeah. Once we got to Wolfson's, they immediately suspected what was going on, and you know, CT scan, MRA, and
and here you see the importance. I think you're thank you for bringing this up, Susanna. I think you're spot on. This can be missed, and it happens sometimes. But he said, Larson described, this is the worst headache of my life. Yeah. Anybody at any age, if this person used that, again, to prove otherwise, this is a brain aneurysm. And again, it's very easy in 2020 to do that. CAT scan, if you don't have an MRI, or in kids who try to avoid CAT scan because of a little bit of radiation on the CT scanners, because of the X-rays on the CT. But again, the risk of a little bit of radiation for a CT versus the risk of missing an aneurysm that bled cannot compare. It's better to get a little bit of radiation to miss a ruptured aneurysm. And I think what you just said here is very important. You got to go to a place that is used to deal with this type of problem and push back. I think what grandma did is phenomenal. Again, there's nothing wrong. Follow your gut feeling. Worst case scenario, you got a scan that you didn't need. Yes, thankfully it was just a stomach virus. There was nothing wrong there. But if you miss the other way around, that can be devastating.
Great information. And I agree with you 100%. Wolfson Hospital, that's what they're there for. And, you know, they have all the proper equipment. Great hospital. So thank you. Larson, how are you feeling now?
I'm feeling wonderful.
We are so happy that you're doing well. We are going to share your interview with the rest of the rest of our viewers. There's people out there who have young children, and it's good for them to learn what to look out for. If something's wrong, we need to react fast. And like what Dr. Hanel said, you know, send them to the right hospital, the hospital that specializes it and that is equipped for it. Correct. So, any final thoughts, Larson, Mrs. Ann, for our viewers?
I'll say, Larson does live with some disability as a result of all that he's been through. He has his left hand and arm is quite impaired.
Yeah, it's weak.
And
this fast yesterday.
And he has short-term memory impairment, which so school is a struggle. He pushes through and works hard, and it's been quite the journey. And
And mom just had a talk with me about the classes I'd be taking, and that of course got me excited for the school year.
Yeah, he starts back to school on Monday.
That's great. Congratulations, Larson. I'm really, really proud of you and your inspiring story. And wow, I mean,
I just want to tell Larson and Susanna that they are true inspiration to me. Those that we have to fight hard, they stay more in our brain. And I think about you guys a lot. When I look at Larson, you are inspiration for me. What you fought through to win this battle. And I'm hoping, as I told you a second ago, that this time we finish this for you. You deserve that. You are phenomenal. And mom, again, this is life is about mother, no matter how old you are. The work that you do there is, I think, if you had 3 gold medals would not be enough for you, because you fight really hard for him. You're talking here with another mother. Olivia is on the other side. That's another 3 gold medal mother. You girls are phenomenal. The work that you do with these kids is, it needs to be on TV. And it's bigger than a lot of things that are taught about and are awarded in this world. Mom rocks. I want to say that this needs to be recorded. Olivia is there. Suzanne is there. The work that you do is very inspiring to me as a doctor and as a father. The amount of time and dedication and energy that you put on these kids is just phenomenal, and I thank you for that.
Susanna, I applaud you because you have other children and this is not an easy task. And for Larson, such a brave young kid, wow. And congratulations. And the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation are forever thankful for you to be part of this, to share your story, because again, you're saving lives out there by just sharing your story. And just know how much we appreciate it and how valuable your information that you're sharing with our viewers as well.
Yeah, well, I was thrilled to be able to meet you by phone and now by Zoom. And, I'm very thankful for the opportunity. If what we've been through can help someone else, that's what it's about.
Awareness is the beginning of the cure. So thank you, Susanna. Thank you, Larson, for sharing this. That's phenomenal. You're not a straightforward case. We know that. And I think people need to be aware of that, because again, we go for perfect every single time. Life is not perfect. A 14-year-old or a 13-year-old in Trinity's case should not bleed from a brain aneurysm. God forbid this happens to kids, but it happens, and we have to fight, and we try our best. We have the greatest tools. We have a lot of experience, but even with that, the results are not perfect, and that's life. And we have to live with that. We have to fight with that. And I appreciate you sharing that. It means a lot to me. And you are helping people. Cannot imagine. And Olivia will tell you that. And I work with other foundations to help kids and help adults. Again, there are people that seek care because, oh, I heard Larson's story. I heard Trinity's story. That's why I'm here. So you are inspiring others, and you're helping others from sharing. So thank you again.
Thank you
so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Today's concert series is being filmed here at Crane Island on Amelia Island, Florida. Crane Island is a Southern Living inspired and coastal living community, and it is our special privilege today to be hosting Mr. Jack Heelan, who is the visionary and the developer behind Crane Island. Jack, thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Why don't you tell us a little bit about how Crane Island came to become a reality?
I got involved at Crane Island really back in 2002 and just kind of fell in love with it. Spent a lot of time walking the property and looking at the beautiful trees. And so my partner, Saad Balan, and I had the opportunity to acquire it in 2014. So we jumped at the opportunity, and my son and I had a vision for how we would like the property to be developed, much like Amelia Island Plantation, in that we protected the natural beauty of the property as much as possible in saving the trees and fitting the homes amongst the trees, but also to bring classic architecture that's timeless to the property, so that when it's finished and fully developed, it looks like it had been here for hundreds of years, and it still was quality architecture and quality built product.
Crane Island offers a unique opportunity to build your dream house within an intimate island community, surrounded by unspoiled idyllic beauty, just a bike ride away from breathtaking beaches, spectacular sunsets, world-class culinary talent, and a true Main Street downtown. All this and more with easy access to a private airport as well as Jacksonville International Airport. It's my understanding you've been here since 1978 in Amelia Island. What does the development of this community mean to you on a personal level, seeing that this is your home?
Well, you know, you want to do something that provides a wonderful place to live for people to live and enjoy, as well as, you know, preserve so that the critters, if you will, that lived here before still can coexist with the people that live here. And that's an accomplishment to people to really have a place that's absolutely gorgeous to live with beautiful scenery and amenities. We emphasize porches. We believe in porch living, creating a community that encourages people to get to know each other and do things together and sit on the porch and have a glass of wine in the evenings and watch the beautiful sunset. So a lot of the homes you'll see have porches, both in the front and the back. So we encourage people to live outside. It's such a beautiful place with natural beauty, and why wouldn't you want to just be in it as much as you possibly can?
Jack, thank you for sponsoring the Trinity Love Hoblit Foundation's concert series, which will support stroke and brain aneurysm awareness. We can't thank you enough for your support.
Glad to do it. It's a great cause.
To learn more about Crane Island or to reach out to John and Jack and the entire team, please visit craneisland.com.
Someday, if you want, you can give me yours too. If you don't, well, I ain't mad at you. Girl, we can still be cool. I'm not trying to pressure you. I just can't stop thinking about you. And you ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend. Said, I just wanna know your name. And maybe sometime we can hook up, hang out, and just chill. The way you walked away, I thought I was never gonna see you no more. Since you didn't wanna give me your mind, I thought that you were digging me and wasn't digging me. Anyway, what you do with tonight, I'll probably be on Amelia Island. If it's cool with you, maybe we'll swing by. You can just chill, or you can just chill with me. Long as you're comfortable and you feel secure when you're with me. Cause I'm not trying to pressure you. Just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my girlfriend. I just wanna know your name. And maybe sometime we can hook up, hang out, and just chill. Let me get the mid-range. Dum-dum-dum-dum-dum. Wanna leave the world I'm with, start a new relationship with you. This is what you do. Think about ringing all the things that come along with you. You made me wanna leave the world I'm with, and start a new relationship with you. This is what you do. Think about ringing all the things that come along with you. Make me. Before anything began between us, you were like my best friend. The one I used to run and talk to when me and my girl was having problems. You used to say it'll be okay, suggest little nice things I should do. When I go home and I don't lay my head down, all I seem to think about is you. Trying to pressure you, just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even been there, gotta be my girlfriend. I just want. Just can't stop thinking about you. You ain't even really gotta be my be my girlfriend. I just wanna know your name, maybe sometime. We can hook up and we can hang out and we can just chill. We can just chill. Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, yes, nice. Yes, yes, yes.
All right, you take the last one.
Whiskey woods, jealous heart, mama, why you cut so deep? All I do is lick my wounds, and baby, all you do is scream. I won't leave, I won't leave. I know I should let you be. I don't know where you are, but mama, please come home to me. Oh, my lovers, whiskey's made a mess of you and me. Oh, my love, I tried a thousand times to let you be, mama. Oh, my love, we don't make love no more, but I still don't get no sleep. This bottle's made a mess of you and me. All night long, your love's strong, strong. Well, it's messing up my mind. When you drink, you get mean. Ah, you treat me so unkind, baby. I won't leave, I won't leave. I know I should have left you a long time ago. But I don't know where you are. Mama, please come home to me. Oh, my love. Don't make love no more, but I can't let you be. Oh, my love, this bottle's made a mess of you. Thank you. tried a thousand times to let you be. Oh, my love, we don't make love no more. I still get no sleep. Oh, my love, this bottle's made a mess. I said this bottle's made a mess. This bottle made a mess of you and me.
Thank you, Dave, Jacob, and Anthony. We loved it. It was absolutely amazing. And of course, none of this is possible without our sponsor, Crane Island, and our production crew from Amelia Island TV. If you would like to learn more about stroke and aneurysm awareness, please visit our website, trinityhoblit.org.